Okay, look, listen. Bro, every time I open up my feed, it's just a bunch of these faceless drones piping up to say that X can beat Dante or Y solos Virgil plus the verse. It's absolutely exhausting. These people don't know a damn thing about Devil May Cry, nor the first thing about power scaling. These YouTube shorts are no substitution for real hypothetical power scaling. Excluding the fact that they are all the same, just someone stating the fact that Dante and Virgil are strong. So far, I've only encountered one of these people that seems to get it. They should be on screen right now. I honestly think it comes from a place of stupidity. A bunch of coomers online keep clicking on Virgil's status and say, "Oh, dude, did you see that? He sheathed and unsheathed his sword and the guy died. How cool." While simultaneously neglecting the lore of Virgil and Dante, so I'll tell you, dumb motherfucker. Dante and Virgil lived in a house with their mom and dad. Peak fiction, I know. And then demons attack when Virgil was fucking off somewhere else and Dante was with their mom, as you can see in Devil May Cry 5. As you probably don't know because you're obsessed with just the pretty anime girl getting cut up and ooh, the storm, bro, he's the storm. Dante hid and survived, later changing his name to Tody Redgrave, so. No, you dumbass. Dante's guns are not stolen. His mom told him to take on a new name, and he listened. With that playing into his character trait of him embracing his humanity and Virgil doing the exact opposite. And Virgil, the blue guy, not the red guy, following me, was left to die with the only thing saving him was his demonic heritage, making him crave power because he was blinded by his trauma and doesn't want to go through that ever again. Bottom line, play the fucking games. Oh my god, and Nero. Don't even get me started on Nero. Nero bodied Dante on the first level he was introduced. No, Dante was literally the tutorial NPC in Devil May Cry 4 for Nero. And one more thing. Whoever you think in your small mind could scratch Dante or Virgil, let alone Nero, get that out of your head. You're wrong and a dumbass. Whatever lame-ass plot device shonen character you think could so much as look at Dante, Nero, or Virgil the wrong way and not be completely obliterated, literally smacked so hard they fell off the page. Get that out of your head because you are blatantly ignorant and uninformed. Here I'll use some terms even a Dragon Ball fan could understand. Virgil possessed the ability to cut through time and space and even destroy it just by existing when he was at half of his strength, even less than that. Dante is Virgil's exact equal in all sense of the term, in anywhere in the universe. In any form I could tell you, Dante and Virgil are the truest forms of equal in existence and outside of it. And I know that you don't know this, but Nero literally punked one of the strongest demons or gods, it's not really explained, ever. He only lost because Capcom is stupid. What I also know your stupid ass doesn't know is the reason that Nero had his arm stolen by Virgil in the beginning of Devil May Cry 5, that's the one you know, was because Yamato was broken after a fight between Dante and Virgil, and Nero found it, and using the blood of Sparta, because as you obviously know, Nero is related to Virgil and Dante, which are the sons of Sparta. Following me? Bottom line, when he pulls his devil trigger, a stand comes out of his back. Yeah, you know that one, don't you? Nero can literally do the same thing that Virgil does to destroy the funny haha anime girl in the beginning of the funny joke, which also makes him as strong as Virgil, which also makes him as strong as Dante, making the triangle. The triangle of fuck you, Goku can't beat me. The triangle of fuck you, Gojo can't beat me. The triangle of fuck you, Asta can't beat me. The triangle of fuck you, Naruto can't beat me. And the triangle of fuck you, the Doom Slayer can't beat me. Just because I'm a demon doesn't mean that you can beat him. Go back to replaying the game that everybody hates you for. You also don't know shit for dick about power scaling. You can't just say that X can beat X because Y. You can't just throw two fictional characters into a room and say, fight. Because by that logic, Super Mario is literally the strongest person in fiction. He just has to jump on their head. There are rules for these fights. We can see that in Devil May Cry. These extremely powerful beings are in our world, so we can quantify their strength with real-world numbers and shit. But no, these YouTube shorts are not a substitute for power scaling. It doesn't matter at all, but it matters to me. So shut the fuck up. Your teen idol character cannot beat Dante, Nero, or Virgil. And no, the cash cows like Dragon Ball, Naruto, or other shonen anime like that can't beat him because they're just gonna give him, oh yeah, fucking multiplied by yes levels of strength because it's what gets you fuckers to pay. I can't just put this down. You guys literally have the wool pulled over your eyes and have the fucking veil of nostalgia put on so thick it's like a lotion. Lotion that blocks any and all logic. Dude. The character you grew up with playing is not going to beat Dante, Nero, or Virgil. And especially meme characters. Metal Gear Rising is an amazing game, but it got popular off of memes. Ha ha ha. I made that game popular, by the way. I'm done being mad. I don't get anything out of this, and neither do you. I could very well turn this into a 3-hour video essay, but I really don't want to, and it's mentally draining to be negative, so. All in good fun, but you guys are dumb. Hey, how you doing? Outro guy here. I really don't want to do any more rants like this because the negativity is just really hard on me. I don't want to sound like a pussy, but having so much venom have to be pushed out of you when you really don't even take it seriously, it is mentally draining. Never do that to yourself. And I want to do some really deep, whatchamacallit it. Video essays. I want to do some passionate stuff with, for some positivity. I have thoughts about Attack on Titan, Mobile Suit Gundam, My Blood Orphans, and of course Devil May Cry. All stuff I'm passionate about. I have no intention of ever becoming a big YouTuber because it just crushes human souls, really. It's really negative. It makes you hate yourself. It makes you hate other people. It's just swirling cesspit of negativity, and negativity is just bad in nature, which is obvious, but still. Have a good day. I want to put stuff out that I can be happy and proud of about, stuff that I'm passionate about, and I'm not passionate about this. I'm not passionate about tearing other people down for stuff that brings them joy. This is a comical rant. You're not supposed to take anything away from it. Really just background noise. Yeah. Can't think of anything else at the moment. Yeah.